In the next 5 minutes, I'm going to teach you everything you need to know to play I Don't Want to Be You Anymore by Billie Eilish. Then I'm going to end this video with an entire song playthrough so you can see the whole thing brought together. So we've got two main guitar parts to learn for this song. If you're a total beginner, you're going to want to start with my free beginner's course and then come back to this video once you've been through that course. For everyone else though, let's get into it. If that's enough for you to get the idea, then you can head on over this time to practice along with a run through of the entire song. For anyone who needs it though, I'm going to walk through these parts in more detail for you right now. So starting on the C chord, we'll go through the strumming pattern used in the intro and the verses. It's going to sound like this. One, two, and a three. Four and a one, two and a three. Four and a. So this one's not too complicated. Everything's down strumming. The only interesting thing is that on the three, you're playing the chord and then you're muting it. So that's just putting the side of your palm here on the strings to stop them from playing. Other than that, there's not too much to it. The one thing you also want to do is the chorus is pretty soft, so you don't want to play it too hard. You want to give it nice, easy strokes to make it smooth and kind of ambient like the song is. Once you can do that, you're going to add in your other chords. The chord progression is going to be C, G, A minor, then back to G. And then you're going to go through that again, except the second time, the last chord is going to be a D instead. And once you can do all that, you can put it all together and you can play the entire part. Then moving into the part playing to the chorus, we're going to do a similar kind of downstrum mute rhythm that's going to sound like this, again starting on a C chord. One and a two, three and a four, one and a two, three and a four. So this is the same kind of downstrum mute rhythm we're doing in the verse, except this time we're muting on the two and the four. So one and a two, mute, three and a four, mute. The other thing to note here is the chorus is livelier, so you want to play this a little more powerful and energetic, though make sure to not play it too hard or else you kind of get ugly sounding chords and we still want things to sound smooth. Then putting together a chord progression, it's going to be similar to the verse, but not the same. We've got C, G, A minor, B, the first time, and the second time, is C, G, A minor, D. Now the one final thing for the section is on that last chord, the B or the D, we're going to take out the mutes and just play straight down strums. So on the B, that's going to sound like this. Or 1 and a 2 and a 3 and a 4 and a. Otherwise, it's pretty straightforward, and if you put that all together, you've got the entire strumming pattern. Then the final part to end off the chorus is just simple down strums held for 4 beats. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. And you're gonna hold the C minor twice as long. If teardrops could be bottled, there'd be swimming pools filled by matters. Told a tight dress is what makes you a whore. If I loved you was a promise, would you break it? If you can play those parts, you can play the entire song. Once you've got those parts pretty solid, you're going to want to follow along and try and keep up with the full song playthrough that I'm going to show you in a second. And if you do that a bunch of times, you'll be jamming out to the song in no time. If you like this video, please hit that thumbs up button, leave a comment in the comment section below, and make sure to hit that subscribe button if you haven't already. And I'll see you in the next 5-minute guitar lesson.